Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's Excel VBA video, we are going to look more and more about cells. In our previous video, we have understood all about cell reference. We have created a macro named cell reference, and using the VB code, we have understood the various methods through which we can refer a single cell or a range of cells in Microsoft Excel. Now, in this video, we are going to continue our discussion on cells, but instead of referring to a cell or a range of cells, what we are going to do in this video is we are going to learn that how can we manipulate the values that is already present in a cell. So, to manipulate the values, we are looking at the different methods. The first method is the previous one only, that how can we add the contents to a cell, to a blank cell. The second method is when a cell is not blank or is having any kind of value, then how can we edit that value to extremely new content, or we can just add something. Suppose hello is written in a cell, then we can write hello world. So how can we manipulate that thing? Then the third thing that we are going to see is what is the method through which we can copy the value of one cell to any other cell. How can we paste that copied value into some other cell? Then how can we cut the value from a particular cell and paste it to any other cell? Now this thing we are going to look firstly at a single cell, and then we are going to see that how these same expressions or same operations could be performed on a range of cells. So this is all what we are going to see in today's video, and let's start with our discussion. So from the previous video only, we have this macro called cell reference, which has no code right now, but I'm going to begin writing the code. So first of all, what I'm going to do is just add some content in a particular cell. The cell I'm using is B3, and in B3 I'm going to change its value, or I'm going to write some content like programming knowledge. Then this is our first step, that is how can you provide a value to a blank cell. If you can just play it, so yes, value is provided to this blank cell. Now this was a string value. How can we provide a numerical value? So say B4, we would provide a numerical value 50. That's our numerical value. Okay. Now, then we have the second thing, that is how can we change the value? Suppose B3's value is programming knowledge, but we want to change it to something else. So how can we do that? Simply, we want to replace its value. So you got to just provide the name. This whole syntax you got to repeat like this. So its value would be changed. For this, we got to use the F8 key for the step into function, programming knowledge 50, YouTube channel. It's been changed like this. Okay. Now, what is the other thing? It is when you want to change its value to something else. Suppose you want to manipulate its value. How can you do that? So let us write something in the cell B5 equals, suppose I write hello. So if I run this function, B5 has got hello in it. Now I decide that I do not want to write just hello, but I want to change its value to say hello world. How can I do that? So that's like concatenating the value. So for concatenation, what you got to do is provide the cell number dot value. This is the same thing that you got to write. Why we are writing this? Because we are trying to change the value. Now we want to keep this hello as it is. So this hello is right now stored in b5.value. So here we got to write b5.value. That is, whatever is the value of b5, you got to write the same thing and then add some other things to it. Now what are these other things? It is a space and word. And then put the double quotes again. Now if I run this, you can see hello world has been written. So this is how you can manipulate the values. If you want to have a clearer look at it, let's start with a step into function. So here you can see when this line is executed, you get hello value in this, but when this line begins its execution, the next line, hello is taken from this plus word is added. If you just execute it, it's hello word. Okay. So this is how it works. This is how you can manipulate the value. Now, how can we copy a value from a cell to other cell? Suppose hello world is the value of B5 and I want to copy it to G10. So how can I do that? First of all, you got to write B5 like this dot copy. Copy is a method. So you got to just write copy. Then what you got to do is paste it in the cell G10. Okay. So when you use this method or property of copy, this hello world is copied into the clipboard, and then you got to provide the target cell where you want to paste it. For pasting, you got to provide with a value known as paste special. When you do that, whatever is copied in the clipboard right now would be pasted in this cell. So if we just run this, then you can see that in G10 hello world is pasted, and this hello world is right now present in the clipboard as evident from this dancing arrows. If you just go to the home tab and try to view the clipboard over here like this, then you can see hello world is present in this clipboard. Okay. And these dancing arrows are present as well. But what if you want to get rid of these dancing arrows? So for that, what you can do is use a simple thing. Write the word application and put a dot. When you do that, you get a list of options. So you gotta go to cut copy mode and put a tab. Now what is this cut copy mode? This cut copy mode ensures that the dancing ends are visible or not. That's a simple thing, but actually it works that whether these dancing arrows or these dancing ends should be visible or not. As we in the Excel, to get rid of the dancing ends, we double click on anything or any cell so that clipboard gets cleared and this cut copy mode is disabled. So this is what we are going to do through coding. So just set it to false like this and put an enter. Now what happens? Let's just use this F8 right now, step into function, so that we can understand everything. First it's hello, then it's hello world. Then its value is copied, then it's pasted, and then as soon as this application dot cut copy mode is set to false, you gotta press F8 and you can see that these dancing ends have been removed. So that is how it works. Now this was about copy. This was about a single cell. What if you want to copy a range of cells and want to paste it? Suppose, first of all, for that purpose, we want to provide a range of data. Suppose from A5 till A10 dot value, we want to provide it with, say, hello. Then, we gotta just run it first. Okay. Now, what do we need to do is just paste it value, paste this value in some other set of cells. Suppose from E7 to E12. Okay. E7 till E12. What do we need to do is provide it with a value dot value. What is going to be its value? The same value that was in A5 till A10. Now let us just all remove this or like this for a cleaner code, and when we run this, okay, dot value. Okay, so if you just provide it with this syntax, then this value is copied over here. And that was the simple thing. on how you can work with the cells, the range of the cells. Now, if you want to use the copy function, how can you use it? Suppose A5 till A10 dot copy is what we do, and then we got to paste it. Where you want to paste it, say in B5 till B10 dot paste special, like this. Okay, now if we run it using F8, it's copied, it's pasted, end sub. Yes, and that's how it works, how you can copy the data from a single cell to any other cell, how you can copy a data from a cell range to other cell range, simply using the value function or the copy function and the paste special function. So that is all from today's video. I hope you all have enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.